You guys, you have to check what I found. I found an amazing derivative calculator, and if you already know about it, which is a website called derivativecalculator.net, then you don't have to watch this video, but actually, stop, don't go away. I want to talk about how the next and next derivatives will be changing and why that's the case. But oh my gosh, when I found this website from the talk I attended, I was shocked. Look at this. So, do you know what derivative is of a sine of a square root of e to the x plus a over 2? All over 2. It's definitely chain rule several times. It will be cosine and then derivative of the square root, derivative of the function inside, and so on. Let's see what's going to happen if I just click the button go. It calculates the derivative, which is like many computer programs can do that. But do you know what's fascinating about this? It gives you steps for free because some programs require you to buy a pro account to have steps. So the original function is here, sine of the square root, blah, blah, blah. The derivative is given over here. And I can, first of all, check the graph. Look at this beautiful graph. It both have the original function in blue and the derivative is in red. I can zoom in this graph and zoom out, and I can see it keep wiggling like crazy. Those wiggles called oscillations because the cosine and sine functions, they oscillate like a sound or waves. So the cool part here is, do you know how they got this result? The derivative is e to the x times cosine and so on and so on. But if I click show steps, are you kidding me? It will show me all the steps. All the chain rule, all the product rule and quotient rule, step by step. That's ridiculously amazing. They're showing me everything in order. Click at any derivative in order to show the rule that was applied. Crazy. So what was the first rule applied? Oh, it was differentiation of the linear function applied. Then here, what did they apply? I'm just clicking randomly. Derivative of the exponential function, e to the x is e to the x. Then what is the derivative of the, how did they get derivative of the square root? Oh, they applied chain rule. The chain rule has been applied here, multiplied by the inner function derivative, u prime. What? This is so amazing. Look at those colors. Look at those steps. And they show you everything. And they even can calculate roots and zeros if you want. Roots or zeros are if I want to find where the derivative is zero. So if I click here, let's see what's going to happen. It should tell me where this derivative is zero. And they found that this derivative is, well, first of all, the original function have roots as well. They gave me this. And derivative have zeros at natural log pi squared minus a. Crazy. Also, when you learn about complex roots, it can do that, and so on. Now, I wanted to say this. Did you see this button? Calculate next higher derivative. Are you kidding me? Let me click. It will calculate the derivative of that crazy function. The function was already insane. Here it is. This is a derivative, the first derivative. It has product rule, quotient rule, and chain rule many, many times. And now it will show me the beautiful derivative, which is a second derivative, as you can see, d2 over dx2, that's f prime prime. And it shows me all the steps. Look at this. Look how beautiful is this. Derivative of cosine u is minus sine u times u prime. Or derivative of the square root of e to the x plus a. Or this guy, the derivative of exponential function. Or where it is the derivative of the product rule. Here it is. Apply the product rule. U times V prime is U prime V plus U V prime. Also, want to point out, it uses my notation, huh? Look how long the process is. They simplified it for you several times. Here it is. No roots though. And the cool part of it that you can still go down and check the graphs. Look at this beautiful graph. It shows me all the derivatives. If I don't want to have them all, I can actually get rid of some. This is the original function. The first derivative is in red and second derivative is in green. And here's the question for you. Why do you think The original function in blue was going like this, like a wave, oscillating, basically wiggling up and down, up and down, up and down. But the first derivative is going up and down, and the range is increasing, like crazy, look at that. And the second derivative is even worse. The second derivative compared to the first derivative goes up right away, much higher. So the green function wiggles much more than the red function, and the red function wiggles more than the blue function. Can you answer this question? What's the difference between all those three functions? Let's check what the original function is. The original function is just a sine. Sine with exponential function inside and a square root. Sine wiggles from minus 1 to 1, right? So the function inside might change the range, but we just know that sine will oscillate. But when I differentiated sine with exponential function inside, due to the chain rule, derivative of the function inside gave me times the derivative of e to the x. And derivative of e to the x is e to the x. So look at the derivative. The first derivative now is cosine times exponential function, right? So now the result is multiplied by the exponential function, which means cosine still wiggles because it's still trigonometric function, right? Goes up and down, up and down. But since it's multiplied by the very fast exponential function, now it wiggles really high and really low. That's the first derivative. Now let's go and check second derivative. The second derivative has more e to the x multiplied by it. Look at the simplified version. It has e to the x, e to the 2x, and so on, again and again and again. E to the 2x is faster than just e to the x. So now the second derivative wiggles even faster and higher and lower than the first derivative, and definitely than the original function. And that's what you can see from the graph. And it's amazing that if you are a visual student and you need to see things after or before you just differentiate, this is an amazing tool for you. The original function goes up and down, but in the range. The first derivative, because of the multiplication by the exponential function, which happens due to chain rule, jumps the oscillation up and down really fast. And the second derivative does it even higher, because now we have more exponential functions multiplied. We can compare, for example, what happens when x is 9. Oh my gosh, it calculated everything right away. And it even showing you where this location is. You see the yellow vertical line? So the original function at 9 is 0.8. The first derivative is already 11, and the second derivative is minus 428. Crazy. So it's jumped down, it's jumped below. Let me zoom out to find it. Oh, I cannot even find where the second derivative is. That's how much it grows by absolute value. What if I do 20? You look how huge the difference is. The original function at 20 is negative 0.9, so it's almost minus 1. But the first derivative is already 2,000, and the second derivative is, how many numbers is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that is 28 millions. Also, you can only zoom, that's what I like a lot, you can only zoom with respect to x, then when you zoom in, it doesn't zoom in with respect to y anymore. And that's more convenient for our example, because now I can see more how it wiggles. So blue is the original function. As you can see, the range for blue is fixed. The green one wiggles, but very high and very low. And the red one is the first derivative, wiggles very high and very low. And the green one even higher and even lower right away. Or you can zoom in with respect to y-axis. But in this case, it doesn't really help a lot. Or you can zoom in with respect to both x and y by changing those properties. This is an amazing finding, and I really recommend you to use it, but not to abuse it. Because now, basically, you can find derivative of any possible functions this program can calculate. You can find first derivative, second derivative, third derivative. As you can see, this button can be touched again, and it will calculate one more derivative, which is going to take a while probably. And your job is not to abuse this tool, because you need to be good at it by yourself. Just letting you know, this is important. We need you to be good at differentiation without any tools, without any calculators, and then without any computer programs. So you can check your homework, you can check everything using this program, but you see I'm saying check, because checking doesn't mean using it to do homework for you. Look how beautiful it is. And as I predicted, third derivative jumps up even higher and sooner, and then jumps down really, really far, because now we have more exponential functions in the answer of the fourth third derivative. Okay, hopefully this video was helpful, and go ahead and play with this program. I'm leaving the link, but it's actually pretty easy to find. Derivativecalculator.net. See you in the next video.